I'm Cormac McSweeney in Ottawa. The people of France went to the polls in their presidential election, and as expected, with 11 candidates in the race and the style of voting system that they have, no one candidate received more than 50% of the vote, which means they're heading to a runoff, with the two candidates being the far right's Marine Le Pen and the more centrist Emmanuel Macron. Now, to talk a little bit more about the French election and what it will mean for Canada, I'm joined now by Maclean senior writer Paul Wells. Thanks very much for being here.
Thanks for having me.
All right, now, I was just actually in Paris on vacation, and I could see from the graffiti on the walls and on the sidewalks to the defaced election signs, this has been a very divisive election. So now that we have this runoff, where do we stand at this point?
Well, it's interesting, almost more for who's not in the runoff. Neither the Gaullist candidate nor the socialist candidate has made it to the runoff. Instead, there are two almost political rookies. We usually pay most attention to Marine Le Pen, the far-right candidate, the daughter of Jean-Marie Le Pen, the founder of the Front National, anti-immigrant, anti-Islamist, anti-Europe, and she has made the runoff. She's running against this guy, Emmanuel Macron, who has never held elected office. He was an appointed cabinet minister under the previous socialist government, and now he's gone off to start his own sort of centrist party that's based mostly on his personality.
It seems like he is getting the backing of other candidates who have lost before this runoff. Does that appear now that he may end up becoming France's next president?
Yeah, I'll be very surprised if Macron is not the next president. Both of the old line parties, the center-right party, which these days calls itself the Republicans, and the socialists, were doing everything they could to, it's a peculiarity of French politics. They were doing everything they could to stop this guy. They don't like him much. They don't think he's qualified to be president, but they sure know they like him better than Marine Le Pen and the far right. So what they're saying is, given that this is the choice, they're urging all of their followers, I mean, this includes the incumbent president, François Hollande, he's saying, vote for Macron.
What effect might this have on our foreign policy?
The Canadian government's been careful not to take a position on this French election, but I would be, my hunch is that they're really looking forward to the idea of Macron being president if he wins. He's from about the same generation as Justin Trudeau. He's actually a few years younger. They agree on the big issues, Europe, NATO, immigration. And at a minimum, even if he winds up having trouble governing France, at least he wouldn't be his own problem the way Donald Trump has been. That would make things difficult for them to manage.
Paul Wells, thank you very much. Definitely a runoff that we'll keep an eye on in the weeks ahead. Appreciate all your thoughts on this. And I'm Cormac McSweeney in Ottawa for City News.